हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम राजगोपाल एक्सप्लेनिंग समथिंग अबाउट द साइबर लॉ। इन द लास्ट फ्यू सेशंस वी हैव कवर्ड सो मेनी सेक्शंस अंडर आईटी एक्ट 2000, पर्टिकुलरली इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड डिजिटल सिग्नेचर सर्टिफिकेट्स, हाउ इट विल बी इश्यूड, how it will be suspended, what do you mean by revocation, how it will be revoked, under which section of our IT Act all these things will be done, under which section of IT Act it is mentioned that how to issue the notice for suspension and revocation, and duties of the subscriber, the act relating to that, and governing of the generating of the key pairs, except when it will be treated as a subscriber has accepted the digital signature certificates, and the control of private key. All these things we have discussed, my dear friends. Today, let us discuss about the penalties, adjudications, compensation for the failure to protect the data, and penalties for failure to furnish the information return, residuary penalties, power to adjudicate, and adjudicating officers. Okay, who will appoint the adjudicating officers, what are his powers, roles and responsibilities, and all these things we will discuss in today's class. Okay, next go to the first topic. What do you mean by a penalty? When the penalty will be issued. Okay, so that is the first point that we have to discuss. The meaning of the word the penalty means a punishment imposed for breaking the rules. If somebody imposes the fine or punishment, that will be known as a penalty. It can be an imprisonment, or it can be a fine, or whatever may be, whatever it suits for that particular crime or criminal activity or for breaking the rules. One example is, if you are traveling in a two-wheeler, if you have not followed certain traffic rules, for example not wearing the helmet, if somebody traffic police questions you, then he can impose a fine of the amount which is prescribed by the law for not following the rules. If you are traveling in a one-way road in opposite direction, then you will be penalized. That is known as the penalty. That is the amount that you have to pay for breaking the rules, knowingly or unknowingly. I am telling you, my dear friends, it is knowingly or unknowingly. Okay, ignorance of law is not an excuse. Okay, that is the meaning of penalty. The suffering in person, rights or property that is annexed by law or judicial decision to the commission of a crime or public offense, this is for breaking the rules. If you have curtailed somebody's rights, or if you have occupied the property of someone illegally, then you will be annexed, you will be put some fine for that, or otherwise you have to give compensation for the loss which has happened to a particular person who is suffering from your occupations. Okay, that is also termed as a penalties. Okay, and the suffering or sum to be forfeited to which a person agrees to be subjected in case of non-fulfillment of stipulations. Okay, this is also one word. Okay, so if the person is suffering from your behavior, okay, from your occupation, from your misuse, knowingly or unknowingly, for that you have to pay the compensation. Okay, that is also known as a penalty or fine or whatever may be, compensation, or it is having its own legal terms. Okay, that is known as, in term, it is a penalties. We will call it as penalties. With respect to the information technology, why you have to give the penalty? When you have to pay the penalties? If you break the rules. Okay, in that aspect, we will discuss what are all the sections will give provisions to put penalties or make you to pay the compensation. That we will discuss in this particular session. Okay, next, the meaning of adjudication. What do you mean by adjudication? It is an act of judging a case, computation or argument. Okay, that is known as an adjudication. Okay, there will be two party who will give complaint, and there will be a person who is accused or whatever may be. Okay, first party and the second party, there is a dispute, and one person will sit in between who will be neutral to both. He will listen to both the parties and he will give the judgment. Okay, he will give the judgment who is wrong, whether the first person or the second person, whether the complainant or the accused. Who is wrong? Who is going against the law? Who has gone against the law? Okay, that will be known as an adjudication, process of adjudication. That includes, okay, who has to approach, which authority you have to approach, what is the jurisdiction of the adjudicating officer, how the adjudicating officer is appointed, all this, what is the provision of law under IT Act 2000, that we are going to discuss in the second topic, that is adjudication. Okay, the process, again one more definition is the process or act of making the official decision about something. Okay, official decision. Two will be bounded to their own decision. Somebody, some third person or an adjudicating officer will decide it legally that he is correct, and you have to go again, somebody has gone against to the law, you have to make a fine amount, you have to pay the fine amount. All these things will be decided by the adjudication. Okay, it is a process of making the official decision about something, especially about who is right in his disagreement. Okay, right in a disagreement. That is the definition of adjudication. Okay, so next, let us take up the matter. Okay, so penalties and adjudication, when it will be done. So, penalties with respect to the Information Technology Act, with respect to the electronic records or anything, will be treated, will be decided. Okay, when any person without the permission of, okay, owner or the authorized person who is having that computer or computer data accesses or secures. First point, there are 8 points which are listed in the IT Act. Okay, for treating a person has committed some mistake. Okay, as a person has made a theft of the database or computer. Okay, in that first point is, if any person, okay, without taking the approval of the owner or an authorized person who is having the computer, if he accesses or secures access to that particular computer, network or database or whatever may be, then he will be penalized for that. Okay, he will be penalized for that. And the second point, if he downloads, accessing means if he enters and if he visualizes, then it is an access. Then the second point is, if he downloads the data or copies, extracts any information which is there in the database, then he will be liable for the penalty. Then he will be considered as a person who is trespassing the computer area. And if a person introduces, or causes to be introduced any computer confinement or computer viruses into the computer system or computer network. If he introduces a computer confinement or viruses into the system, means then also he can be penalized. Then also he will be treated as a person who has trespassed the area of a particular computer. Then the fourth point, disrupts or damages or causes disruption of any computer, computer part, or anything, hardware, software, or whatever may be. And the sixth one, denies access. If somebody denies the access of a computer, computer network, database, or whatever may be, if you are authorized to enter into that, then also he is eligible for the penalization. He is eligible for the penalty. He will be considered as a person who has not given an access to a place where you can enter into. Either it may be a computer, or it may be a network, or it may be a database, or whatever may be. If somebody denies the access, if you are an eligible user of that, then also he is eligible. The person who denies is eligible for penalization. Or he is eligible for adjudication in this particular matter. That is the fifth matter. And then if any assistance to any person to facilities to access the computer or computer network in contravention of provision of this act, rules and regulations made thereunder. And the second and the last point is, are charges the services availed by the person to account of another person by tampering, he can be fined up to 1 crore rupees. If there is a, depending on the damages that he has done for a particular system, up to 1 crore rupees he can be penalized. This is provided in the section 43 of Information Technology Act, my dear friends. Section 43 of Information Act will clearly mentions with some 8 to 9 points who is eligible for the penalty. The penalty will be levied on a person who accesses, trespasses the area of the computer, and the person who denies the access of the computer or a database or a network. If a person is eligible, if one person is eligible to enter, he is authorized to enter, if somebody denies the access, means then also he can be penalized under this section 43 of IT Act. I have used a few words here, my dear friends. I have used few words. Let us go into the meaning of that words. What do you mean by a computer confinement? These words are used in IT Act 2000. Similarly, the explanation is also given under section 43 of IT Act. What is the meaning of a confinement? Computer confinement means any set of computer instructions that are designed, first one, to modify, destroy records, transmit or any data or program residing within a computer or computer network. A computer confinement means a software or a hardware which is designed to modify, record, destroy, transmit any data or program residing within the computer or computer network. It can be anything, which is used. It may be a hardware or a set software or whatever may be, which is designed to modify, take out the information, then it is known as a computer confinement. For example, you may insert a pen drive into the system to introduce a malware into a particular system, which will destroy the entire system itself. okay, which will destroy or which will destroy the, modify the records which are present in that particular data system, then it is known as a computer confinement. Or any means to disrupt the normal operation of the computer system or any network. If you disrupt any of the normal operations by introducing some external hardware or software, or the software that you will send through the network, then also it will be considered as a computer confinement. And the next, computer database. You all know what you mean by a database. It refers to the representation of information, knowledge, facts or instructions in text, image or audio, video that is prepared or has been prepared in a formalized manner. Okay, that is known as a computer database. Okay, with respect to the IT Act 2000, okay, it may be a video, audio which is stored in a particular order in a system, then it is known as a database. Okay, damage means if you destroy, alter, add, modify, rearrange any of the computer resources, then it is known as a damage. Okay, it is not only a physical damage. Okay, you may break the computer or you may destroy the computer by some of your activity, or you may alter the database which is stored in a computer system. If you add something to your something to the database which is present, or if you modify any data which is present in the particular computer or in the network, or if you rearrange any of the computer system, everything, all these acts according to the section 43 of the Information Technology Act, it will be considered as a damage. Okay, it will be considered as the damage to a particular system. And then computer virus. All of you know it is a software or whatever may be which will destroy the normal operation of a computer. Refers to any computer instruction, information, data or program destroys, degrades, adversely affects, okay, the other computer, another computer resource, in if the instruction is executed. Okay, if you execute that, if you download that particular system, if you download that particular software, it will degrades or destroys or whatever may be, that is known as a computer virus with respect to section 43 of Information Technology Act. The virus will be, you have already discussed, you have already come to know in the previous sessions while discussing the cryptography, what is malware, what is virus, what is the damage, all these things, what do you mean by database, all these things you have come to know, you have enough idea about all these things. What I am explaining here to you now is with respect to the IT Act. The section 43 of IT Act will give an explanation about all these points. Okay, meanings will be explained, what it mean according to the Information Technology Act, how it has to be decided, how the case has to be decided if this particular word comes into picture. Okay, that is the meaning of that. Okay, let us go to the next point, next section, that is, my dear friends, here in the section 43 we have discussed what is the penalty for the damage to the computer or computer system. Okay, under this section only a 43A will come into picture, which will clearly explains what is the compensation that you will get for the failure to protect the data under section 43. Okay, under section 43, what is the penalty, what is the compensation that you will get under section 43A for the failure to protect the data. Failure to protect the data means your personal data. Okay, your personal data. The personal data means, okay, according to this act, the personal data, what the legal authority means it can be your password. Okay, any financial information such as bank accounts, credit card details, all these things, and physical, physiological, mental health conditions of a person, that will also be known as a personal data. Okay, any hospitals will be having your database. Okay, it has been, if it has been leaked, if it has been transferred, then you have eligible. If somebody misuses, okay, then it will be considered as, then you are eligible for the compensation of data. If any data which is transferred with the sexual orientation, okay, then also it will be, then the person will be eligible for the compensation. That will be a institute is failed to protect the data. Okay, is failed to protect the data, then that will be considered, you will be considered for the compensation. Or biometric information, any of the biometric information, if it is leaked, if somebody misuses that biometric information, either it may be your thumb impression or it may be an iris impression or whatever may be, if somebody misuses that, then also you will be eligible for compensation. Okay, and these are will be considered as your personal data, okay, for which you are entitled for the compensation. Here one case study I can give you, my dear friends. One case between Pune Auto Ancillaries Private Limited versus, okay, Punjab National Bank head office situated at New Delhi. Okay, one company called Pune Auto Ancillaries Private Limited has lodged a complaint. Before that, this company has answered to a phishing mail. Okay, it has been answered to a phishing mail. The company CEO or somebody, he is Rajesh Agarwal, okay, Matru, has lodged a complaint. He has answered to a phishing mail. After answering to a phishing mail, a sum of rupees 85 lakhs has been withdrawn from his account through that phishing mail. Okay, what is phishing? All these things you know. Okay, with that, he has answered to that phishing mail unknowingly. With that, sum of rupees 85 lakhs has been withdrawn from his account. Okay, where the decision by the corporate authority has given the decision. Okay, some authority has given the decision that, okay, both are responsible for the activity. Okay, because Mr. Matru has answered for the phishing mail. Okay, he has responded for the phishing mail knowingly or unknowingly. Okay, for his negligent behavior, and the bank, that is Punjab National Bank, has failed to maintain the confidentiality of that particular account. Okay, failed in its security procedures, failed in the security procedures, and the loss was, damage was done to that particular company. Okay, damage was done to the particular company. So both were held responsible, and the decision has made, okay, either it may be an appellate tribunal decision or whatever may be, the decision has made the Punjab National Bank to pay the highest penalty of 45 lakhs to the complainant, okay, to the complainant, that is Mr. Matru. Okay, but he has lost nearly 85 lakhs. Okay, since he has answered the phishing mail, since he has been trapped with the phishing mail, he should have been, he should not be so negligent in that. Okay, that decision has been given, and under this particular act, Compensation to the Failure to Protect the Data Act, Section 43, Punjab National Bank has been penalized ₹43.45 lakhs, as a compensation amount to the complainant of this particular case. This is how Section 43A is effective. It will tell that a body should protect, if a corporate body should protect who is possessing your data, should protect your data. Somehow, if there is a leakage of that particular data, then the corporate company or the person who is responsible will be penalized for that particular act. Who will be legalized for the particular act. Same one more case study in this particular act under Section 43 is, it is between a dropout student from the Rajasthan and between the Jio, subscriber data leak matter. Here, Jio owned by Mukesh Ambani, a data has been leaked. A FIR has been filed by the Jio, telling that its data has been leaked. There will be a theft of data from its database. Then the police has lodged a complaint. Jio company has lodged a complaint. Police have done an FIR. Under Section 379 of Indian Penal Code and Section 43 of IT Act with respect to data theft. And that particular college dropout from Rajasthan has been arrested in Rajasthan. He has produced before the magistrate in Rajasthan and he has brought to Navi Mumbai for further inquiry. He has been inquired, how the theft has been done. And then, forensic report has been taken. How the data has been taken out, whether the company personals are responsible in leaking this data, any of the company official has been paid for this illegally. To inquire into all this matter, that case has been registered. This is the best example for the Section 43 of Information Technology Act. A person will be, FIR will be filed against him. He will be taken into the custody and a rigorous inquiry will be done. And if he has taken that and if he has made some money out of it, from the data, whatever he has taken it out, with that he will be penalized and he will be punished for that particular act, whatever he has done. So this is about the Section 43 and 43A of the IT Act, my dear friends. Next, Section of one more section is there, Section 43 of Information Technology Act and Section 44 of Information Technology Act. If there is a he can be penalized for any other person, and Section 45 will also give the residual penalty. Residual penalty means if some activity through which a particular person suffers. For that, the person who has made, the accused has to pay some penalty, that will be come under residuary penalty, that is under Section 45 of Information Technology Act. a penalty for the failure to furnish the information. Okay, if somebody fails to furnish the information, then also under that section also he can be penalized. Okay, some fails to furnish any document, written or report to controller, CA, shall be liable for a penalty not exceeding 1.5 lakhs. Here it has been wrongly mentioned, my dear friends. Here it is section 43, not it is section 40, it is not section 43, it is section 45 of Information Technology Act. It is section 45 of Information Technology Act, my dear friends. Okay. Under section 45 of Information Technology Act, 44, sorry, section 44 of Information Technology Act, if somebody fails to furnish the information, for example, as I have told, there will be a certifying authority, they have to file certain information timely to the controller. If they fail, then it can be a penalty, it can be up to 1.5 lakhs. If a person fails to furnish his income tax details, how much he has paid, how much he is eligible for the payment of the income tax, if he fails, then he can be penalized. Depending on the amount, depending on that, he can be penalized. Whatever may be, if some person fails to furnish the information to an authority, then he will be penalized under section 44. Here wrongly it has been typed. It is section 44 of Information Technology Act. Okay, and the section 45 will give the residuary penalty, as I have discussed, for any of the act which will make the other person to face a loss or whatever may be. Under this act, the person who is responsible for that loss will be made to pay the penalty. Okay, it can be up to 25 lakhs, or it will depends on the, if it is a huge amount, the penalty amount may increase. Okay, if somebody is taking undue advantage of that, what is the advantage he has taken out of it, based on that also a person will be penalized. Okay, so that is section 45 of Information Technology Act. Next, the section 46 of Information Technology Act, power to adjudicate. For this purpose, for the purpose of adjudicating, central government shall appoint an officer not below the rank of director to the Government of India or an equivalent officer of the state government to be an adjudicating officer. Okay, any director, rank of director, will be appointed as an adjudicating officer to adjudicate any matter with respect to this particular Information Technology Act. If the person is eligible for penalty, means he, what is the amount of penalty that he has to pay, why he has to pay, that will be decided by the adjudicating officer. Okay, that will be decided by the adjudicating officer. That adjudicating officer is appointed by the central government. He is the rank of the director to the Government of India or equivalent officer of the state government, who will be appointed as adjudicating officer. And one more important thing, he shall exercise the jurisdiction to adjudicate the matter in which the claim for the injury or damage does not exceed 5 crore. Okay, here the, in this provision, it is maintained that the compensation up to 5 crore he is eligible for the adjudicating. That officer is eligible for adjudicating if the fine amount is up to 5 crore rupees. If it exceeds, then the next authority will come into picture. Okay, up to 5 crores he can adjudicate, he can give the decision in this particular matter. Okay. And the conditions for adjudication. Okay, under what conditions he can be adjudicate. The adjudicating officer shall give a reasonable opportunity for making the representation in the matter. Both the parties will be given an equal, timely opportunities to produce the document, to have a representations, to give their representation before the adjudicating officer. A proper time has to be given and reasonable opportunity has to be given, and the adjudicating officer should hear both the parties equally, and then he has to give the decision in that particular matter. Okay, the second point, the adjudication officer shall have the proper experience in the field of information technology. An adjudicating officer, while appointing the central government, has see that he is having a proper experience in that particular information technology field. Okay, he has to verify the so many conditions. While adjudicating. Okay, what do you mean by computer? What do you mean by virus? What is the mal virus? What is the digital signature signature certificates? What are all the conditions that has to be maintained? So many issues will come into picture. Okay, a person who has worked in this field thoroughly, okay, who is having experience, practical experience in this field, should be appointed as adjudicating officer. And the adjudicating officer, once after he has been appointed, he will be having the power of civil court under section 193 and 228 of Indian Penal Code. He will be having the civil court power, and the proceedings are considered as a judicial proceedings. It is equivalent to a court, and everybody will be abide by the proceedings, and everybody should give the respect as with respect to the court only under section of 345 and 346 of CRPC, Criminal Procedure Code. He will be having the judicial powers. Proceedings are considered as judicial proceedings. Okay, so that is the condition for the adjudications. Okay, and then what are the factors that has to be taken by the adjudicating officer, that is the AO? So any court proceedings means any judicial authority which is having the power of civil court means it has to take some procedures. It has to follow certain procedures. Means both the parties should be allowed to represent the case, to give their evidences, okay, to argue on the evidences, and an opportunity has to be given to go through the evidences what the opposite party has submitted. Okay, a copy has to be given to the opposite party what the evidence has been given. Okay, fair amount of time has to be given for the preparation to submit the matter, and a proper opportunity has to be given for the arguing in that particular matter. Then only the adjudicating officer has to give his decision based on the arguments from both the party, based on the evidences submitted by both the parties. Okay, so that is how the proceedings has to take place before an adjudicating officer. So here, factors that has to be taken care by the adjudicating officer is the amount of gain or of unfair advantage. What is the amount of unfair advantage that one person has taken by stealing that particular data, by stealing that particular property, by the trespassing the property? Okay, either it may be a computer property, intellectual property, or whichever type of property it may be. He has to see that what is the unfair advantage that one particular person has taken by occupying or by trespassing one's data. Okay, that is the one thing. Wherever qualifiable, made as a result of default. Based on that only he has to give the decision what should be the fine amount, how much compensation that he has to give, what is the amount of loss that has occurred to the complainant of that particular case. Okay, the next is the amount of loss that is caused to any person as a result of default. Okay, what is the amount of loss that one has faced for that particular loss of property or for particular damage of that particular computer or whatever may be. Okay, and repetitive nature of default. If the default has been done again and again, you might have seen in the traffic rules. One example that I can give at this point is, once if you have broken the traffic rules, the amount will be 1000. If you have been penalized for the same offense second time, the penalty amount will be more than that. And again, if you are breaking that rules again and again repeatedly, if you are habitual, okay, if you are habitual in this nature, the amount of penalty, amount of punishment that will be given will be different. Okay, once it will be penalized, okay, you will be penalized for that particular offense with a minimum amount. With a minimum amount, that will be a first thing that will be done. If you repeat the same type of failures again and again, after knowing that you will be penalized for that, the penalty amount will increase heavily. And even if you will be penalized with an imprisonment also, for that matter, okay, any type of actions, related actions can be executed by the court in that particular matter. That is the repetitive nature of default. Okay, if it is a repetitive nature of default. Okay, so with this, we will conclude this today's session. Today we have discussed more about the penalties and adjudications. Okay, who will be the adjudicating officer? Under what circumstances, an adjudicating officer will be appointed? What is his qualification? What is the power of the adjudicating officer? How he has to give the opportunity to both the parties to represent their case before him? All these things we have discussed. Again, the references, your prescribed book, and the BEAR Act of Information Technology 2000. Okay, with this we will conclude today's session. Thank you one and all.